is Mike Chavez. He's famous, well, at least in the motorcycle industry. This is the 19 KX250. No more F.
No more F.
Because everybody, I heard it's just like, hey, we know it's a four-stroke, right?
Right. All right. So they drop the F.
So drop the F. So Mike, tell us about this bike. Obviously, the big news is that the motor is different. Tell us about the motor.
All right. The motor no longer has the double overhead cam with bucket system. So now it uses finger followers. It has two cams over finger followers. And no more buckets. So shim on top of, or finger followers on top of the shims, and cams on top of the finger followers.
Okay, and I noticed the throttle body is now on a better down angle, right?
Yeah, better down angle, and the throttle opens now in a forward position. The flap?
Yeah, the butterfly thingy.
Yeah, the butterfly thingy now opens in a forward position.
Okay, and the muffler looks a little cooler. Tell us about that.
So the muffler is quieter. So now, you know, we've gotten rid of that loud muffler sound.
Are you saying this bike was loud before?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay.
So, so it's quieter now.
Now, then the next big news, let's move up here, is a hydraulic clutch.
Hydraulic clutch.
And I noticed that it's like the components up here,
yep,
are just like the front brake. It's really cool. Like,
yeah, it's made by the same company that makes the front brake.
Yeah, the line looks just like heavy Nissan. Duty.
Yeah, Nissan brake. And it also has play in the lever, which guys like, which just gives you the feeling of like a clutch.
Yep.
So it doesn't just have that complete on and off feeling.
So yeah, you have that little play like you did with a cable clutch.
Yep.
So if you keep that much play in there, I like that. And then down here is where the slave cylinder is to push in. And yep. Also, what's this thing?
So that's electric start.
Whoa! So that's pretty big news.
Like so, that. Yeah.
You hit it once, it wakes up the fuel pump. I always tell people to do that. That's a good idea.
Yeah, it kind of primes the fuel pump.
Yep, and then kind of wakes up the battery and everything.
Yep.
New air filter in the box, in here?
Yeah, new air filter. So now you don't have to remove the seat anymore to get to the air filter. So you just take out these two bolts, okay, and the air filter will come out, and the air filter is sitting right there.
Okay, and it is new from the 18 filters.
Yeah, filter's different shape. It's a little flatter, okay, a little wider in diameter, or bigger in diameter.
Okay, so now the other big news is you don't need your air pump with this bike anymore, I heard.
Yeah, no more air pump. So yeah, we went to spring fork now.
Dual springs.
Dual spring.
Is this Showa?
It's Showa, and it's they call it A-Tech. It's like the A-Kit. So A-Kit technology. Which basically the Showa guys looked at this thing and they said basically it's the same stuff that they use.
That's
as far as like their factory stuff.
They're pretty looking.
Yeah.
Got the DLC looking coating here.
Yeah, bigger diameter piston.
And I'm sure the shock's been updated.
Shock's been updated, yes.
Okay, so we got new frame to fit this stuff in, I'm guessing.
Yep, frame stiffer.
And how much of the plastic's different? Is all the plastic different?
All the plastic is different other than the front fender and the number plate.
Front fender, number plate, you could recycle.
Yep.
Fork guards are different.
Fork guards are different. Shrouds, number plates, fender.
Looks like you could maybe bolt Honda fork guards on there. I don't want to tell you that, but. Okay, but everything looks amazing. I'm going to see what Ping thinks of riding this thing. I'm not a 450 guy, you know, unfortunately. I got too many bruises and scars.
But you're going to give it a lap, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
A couple laps.
But I can't ride it for real, or yeah, my wife will kill me. So, but it's really, really nice looking bike. Everything I've heard from all the guys that have ridden it they're in love with it. They're really liking it. And it sounds like it gained about 2 pounds.
2 pounds.
Which puts it, when I looked at my list, puts it about the middle of the 450s. You have all the 450s, the KTM being a lot lighter, the Honda, Suzuki, and Yamaha all being heavier. So if that's true,
we like to say it's the lightest of the Japanese bikes.
Lightest. So that's one for you to remember. It's the lightest of the Japanese bikes. So really cool looking bike. Thanks Cha for going over this thing with us.
Thank you.
All right, Ping, you just hopped off this thing. What do you think?
I love it. I wasn't sure. This is day two on it for me, and I really loved this bike at the intro. And I wasn't sure if maybe I was just having a good day that day or whatever, but I jumped back on it and it just feels right at home again. I absolutely love the fork. I I would argue this is the best production fork ever put on a dirt bike. The way the power comes on, it's just the throttle response is incredible. It feels very light and maneuverable, which is a departure from the old Kawasaki's to me. And the corner's great. I mean, literally, I don't have any complaints on this thing right now. So we're trying to work through any issues that there might be, and I don't really have any issues, so I'm not sure what to do. I really like the Cali.
That's awesome. All right, well, thanks a ton. We'll see you.
All right.